The debate. In matters of heterosexual courtship, should a man pay for a woman's sh-? There is so much to unpack here, so I want to break this down into three categories. The first date, the relationship, and
the marriage.
Disclaimer, if you are new to my channel, most of my videos are orientation and gender agnostic. However, today's discussion obviously pertains to the heteros, and yes, we are seriously disturbed. This is obviously a hotly debated topic, and I know y'all want the fairy godmother's take. Who even is this bitch? I've never heard of her. My personal opinion is that yes, a man should pay on the very first date. Three reasons for this. Reason number one, let's be real, some men are dangerous as f-. I mean, we all watch the news. So just by showing up to this date, the woman is assuming some serious risks to her safety. So the least a man can do is pick up the bill. Two, due to our patriarchal societal norms, the woman is probably gonna put way more effort and money into the date itself. I mean, when I have a date, I pick my outfit, I moisturize, apply foundation, mascara, blush, highlight, lip, and that's not even counting the hair routine. Meanwhile, the guy probably washed his face with dish soap, ran a comb through his hair, and called it a day. So again, the least you can do to counteract the $80 of Fenty Beauty on my face is pay for my $11 drink. Sorry. And three, I mean, he's just a man. He gets to be president and shit, he gets paid more and shit, his bodily autonomy isn't illegal in 11 US states and counting, so just pay for the damn date.
This is assuming that the first date is something like a drink or a coffee. If it's a whole ass dinner at a decently nice place, I see the argument for splitting, but also, if you can't afford to be taking people on dinner dates, don't ask them on dinner dates.
So in terms of the people who think a man should pay for dates throughout the relationship, I think there's two camps. One is the people who are just all in on gender roles. The woman is a pretty fairy, the man is a provider, and I have a lot of shit to say to you guys, but we'll get to that in the marriage section. Then there's the women who are still feminists and still want an overall equal relationship, but at the same time, they want to be wined and dined, financially spoiled by their man with zero reciprocation. And on that, I'm gonna call bullshit. First of all, paying for dates will add up very quickly. In this economy, on the surface, it's like, oh, he paid for dinner, cute. But when you go to a decently nice place,
you get drinks, you do this every weekend, add in other meals, activities, movies.
Girl, that's a month's rent. And unless he's making significantly more money than you, it's just not fair. Damn. I'm a feminist, okay? It's really not about defending men. It's about the fact that any sense of extreme unfairness or overt imbalance in a relationship is gonna fuel resentment, which we all know is one of the biggest relationship killers.
Hope she's enjoying the free ride. I'd like to be wined and dined. For once.
Having him pay for everything can also open up the space for more gender roles to seep into your dynamic. I mean, maybe you start doing more around your apartment because he's paying for more, and pretty soon you're in a full-blown patriarchal relationship that you did not sign up for. But he's a man, fairy thought mother! I mean, you just said they need to pay for their sins on the first date! Exactly. On the first date. But once you enter into a relationship with someone, they're no longer just a man. They're your partner. There's someone that's hopefully bringing emotional and spiritual value into your life, so stop trying to bankroll them. Please! So, I'm sitting here editing this video, realizing that I probably bit off more than I can chew, because gender roles, it's a big topic. But for the sake of this video, I just wanted to make sure that I said the quiet, uncomfortable part out loud, and that is this. When you embrace the idea that men should be paying for your shit, whether that's meals or gifts or even like a house down the line, you are basically saying that your presence, your very being, is a commodity that can and should be purchased by men. I don't care whether you're saying that because you really do believe in gender roles or because you're a feminist who thinks getting money from men is somehow empowering. There is nothing empowering about selling your presence for money. In fact, that's the literal definition of objectification. And I don't know about you guys, but the absolute last place that I want to bring that toxic dynamic is into my relationship with my partner, my best friend, the person with whom I'm sharing love and light and care on a daily basis, and suddenly I'm going to turn to that person and say, actually, no. If you want to be with me, you better pay up. Like, what the f-? Anyway, back to the who should pay conversation. Now, I'm not saying that you should never let your boyfriend take you out for a nice meal, because like I said before, women are dealing with a whole lot of shit that men are not, and I still think it's a nice gesture every once in a while. But the second it goes from an occasional sweet gesture to something that's just expected in the dynamic of your relationship, that's when it becomes a problem. If you're enjoying this content and you're a bad bitch, I trust that you'll hit subscribe for more and respectfully smash that like button. Thanks, daddy.
Marriage.
In two parts.
Part one, the fallacy of the 50-50 marriage.
Now, obviously, I'm a 50-50 girly, or at least a both parties pay proportional to whatever they make girly. But the truth is that most 50-50 marriages are not actually 50-50. I mean, yeah, the bills might be split in half, but due to ongoing patriarchal norms, women are still doing most of the household chores, planning the kids' schedules, organizing vacations, and all sorts of unseen labor. And that's not 50-50, that's, a ripoff. A lot of people think that the solution here is to just have the man pay more bills to make up for the woman's unpaid labor. But I don't really buy that. Not only does this reinforce problematic patriarchal values, it doesn't really make sense because we can't really quantify the unseen labor women do, and because of that, we can never determine what's actually a fair trade. The better solution, in my opinion, is an actual 50-50 marriage. Split the bills, split the household and logistical work. And yes, achieving this is gonna take time, effort, and sometimes uncomfortable communication. But I firmly believe that it's worth it, both in terms of creating a truly equitable partnership and in terms of setting a better precedent for future generations. Oh, humanity has about 50 years left? Okay, never mind the second part. Part two, the fallacy of housewifery. Girl. In a society where workers are underpaid and underappreciated, the housewife thing is starting to look like a pretty sweet deal.
I mean, you don't have to work. Everything's free. You just tend to the garden like a pretty fairy.
Oh, one moment here. Breaking news. It appears we've already tried that for much of human history, and it doesn't end well for women. Not only is being a housewife boring and literally depressing as hell, you're placing your entire livelihood into the hands of someone else.
Unfortunately, a lot of women have no choice but to stay home due to the abhorrent cost of childcare in the US, other financial factors, and even just societal and family pressure. So I don't say any of this to blame or shame them because it's not their fault we live in a late capitalist patriarchal society. Who I am speaking to is the young women who naively think that being a housewife is a cute or appealing option. The truth is it comes with some pretty serious downsides and risks that need to be acknowledged and seriously considered. All of which I will discuss right the fuck now.
I mean, sure, it seems like a good idea when you're young and in love, but what if he becomes abusive? Or he cheats on you? Or you just fall out of love with him? And now you're in a situation where it's incredibly difficult, if not impossible, to leave because this man is literally your source of food and shelter. Meanwhile, he has his own job, his own money, so he could leave you at any time. And now you're jobless with no work experience and two kids to feed in a system that's rigged against women, working mothers, and people in poverty.
Let me hear say uh-oh!
Here is not to say that, oh, you shouldn't trust anyone because he could leave you at any time and he's gonna run off with his secretary. My point is more to say that over the course of like a 20, 30, 40 year marriage, plans change, feelings evolve. And the other caveat is that I am not saying you both are gonna be working your entire lives and completely 50-50, because the nature of any relationship is reciprocity, right? It's back and forth. I mean, when I've just had a baby and my hoo-ha is in stitches, yeah, I'm gonna expect my man to carry the team for at least a few months, but that's with the understanding that if he ever needed me to carry the team, if he ever got laid off or needed to take a few months off working for any reason, I would be prepared to do that. Like, that's what a relationship is. It's give and take. But that is such a different story than planning out a 30-year marriage based on him being the provider and you being the stay-at-home mom.
Have you ever been dating a man and been like, he says he's a feminist, but I'm not so sure? Well, fear not, because I made a video outlining the top 6 subtle signs of misogyny that you might miss, but you definitely want to pay attention to. Bye, thotties!